Most of you people have been around long enough, I actually feel kind of comfortable, and I can finally, after all these years, show you my hammer. What? Why are you laughing? Why are you laughing? Why are you laughing? The AC is on high in here, man. This never happens. It's usually huge. Today, we are taking a look at the VAS for Video Aerial Systems SkyHammer. I really like almost all the products I've gotten from Video Aerial Systems, except for maybe one or two things. Almost the other 99.9% stuff worked really well for me. When Alex announced, his name's Alex, I don't remember his last name, but when Alex announced the SkyHammer, I was really, really super excited. I was so excited, I got two. Because in theory, it would make me the RF bubble boy. I'd be like surrounded by RF receptivity, if that's even a real word, all around me. Previously, I've always used the ions, the VAS ions. So I thought those were the best antennas ever made because my reception went from to that. Right, like taking Viagra. Boom! Here are my regular Doc Brown Back to the Future special. And you can see there are the Ion V1s. These things have been just like a godsend. And I have been using them now for a year easily, if not longer. The VAS Ions are 2.5 dBi, which is a pretty good signal for a Omni. You don't really get that too often. When these had come out, I think these were the highest. Now I guess some people are getting a little bit higher on that, but I think the highest I've ever seen was 2.2, this goes 2.5. Enter the SkyHammer, the VAS SkyHammer. Supposedly, you would be getting 5.25 dBi from this setup right here, 360 degrees. Null points are up at the top, so we're only talking horizontally, we're not talking vertically. Unless, in my Alex Hargraves, I think his last name is. In my non-VAS thinking mind, I thought, okay, then I'll put one on like that, and I have this way, and I have that way. Circle! Circle bubble! Now, I have to say, I'm just going to say it again. I'm a big VAS supporter, okay? VAS has always put stuff out. IBCrazy has always put really, really, really good antennas. Like I said, very few have ever let me down. And so here comes the spoiler alert. If you don't want to know yet, I'll give you 5 seconds to go. I can't operate on my fingers. Okay, time's up. I was not pleased with these. And I don't know why. I tried several configurations where I would have this set up, and I did use these, but I also did use the rapid fire. So I had these. If you look at this picture, this is good old Benjamin. I made him wear this.
Look at this. Totally normal.
I just like to make Ben look wacky.
I made him wear this contraption you're looking at right now. And even though I knew there'd probably be some dBi loss because of the length of one of the extenders, I said, the heck with it, let's give it a try first. At 25 milliwatt, Mr. Benjamin was pretty happy with the difference.
I haven't seen one breakup yet.
So yes, it's better than your other antennas.
Is that better than yours then?
Yes.
Okay, so there you go.
You win.
I win the internet today.
I think for the most part, it operated good for him. As I looked at his video, I could see small differences, but I didn't see big differences. Then I went to my good friend Q, FPV, and I said, hey man, you wanna try these out? He goes, heck yeah. I go, what kind of receiver you got? He goes, oh, I got that true 3D, 3.7 version. I went, okay, that should be fine. And he put it on and he promptly said,
I'm still getting breakup over in the areas where I got with mine though.
And I said right back to him, heresy!
Q just got done and didn't help you on the true D.
Nah, still still
sketch
up over in the areas back where my original setup.
Blasphema! How could VAS not be that good? You, sir, are damned to hell. Up to that point, I didn't try the antennas out at first. I let my friends take it first and say, here, try these out, see what you think. And, you know, I'll go on what you said. Okay, so we got one loves it, one that was speaking heresy and crimes against humanity, and then me who didn't know any better because I didn't use them yet, right after this event.
Well, as is true with Florida weather, you don't like the weather, just wait a couple of minutes. I don't know anyone I was helping for that though.
A few of us went to a new location and I got to try these for the first time. I flew 25 and 200 on this, 25, 200 on this. And we're gonna look at that video now, and at the very end, don't skip ahead, at the very end, I will tell you which antenna is which. But in the meantime, I want you to guess. You know, which one do you think is which? Left is left the hammer, SkyHammer, or is left the ion? Go ahead, have fun with it. What did you think? Leave your comments down below. I myself am just a little bit disappointed because if you add up, and I don't know if it's additive, but I'm gonna say it is. If you add up 5.25 here and 5.25 here, that makes 10.50 dBi. This is only 5. This should have been almost HD quality. Okay, well not HD, but really good. I shouldn't have had a lot of signal lost. Or in theory, I shouldn't have. Again, I am not VAS systems. I don't have half the knowledge Alex has. All I am is a stupid consumer who bought his antenna thinking, wow, I could be RF bubble boy. Let's take a look at the graphs for a second. So you can see on the left-hand side is the VAS systems antennas and what the gain chart shows you is on the side. So anything approaching pink, red, and orange, and the darker side, the upper part of the scale, is supposed to be where your sweet spot is for reception. You can see that's kind of a narrow beam going out, but around you, it's all 360. On the other side, I just wanted to simulate what I thought the bubble was gonna look like. So there is a vertical gain chart and a horizontal gain chart. And I thought I would be within that bubble, but if you really look closely, and this is my mistake, I'm not gonna pretend to say, you know, that I'm an expert at this. The projection going forward is only about 20 to 30 degrees. I thought it was gonna be bigger because I thought it was gonna look more like the ion. So, that said, I thought I was in the bubble. And I'm heartbroken, I'm not. I'm out of the circle of trust. I think that maybe a change in the description for this antenna should be made. Because, like I said, not the brightest bulb on the chain, but I do understand things. And I understand that, you know, I have circular reception except to the null points in the front. But I thought that was gonna be overridden by having them this way, and I don't want you to make the wrong mistake. These are essentially 360 degree panels. Whether they're omni-shaped or not, they still operate like 360 degree panels. Like TrueRC has 180 degree panels. These are 360, think of them as 360 degree panels. Before you buy them, make sure you need it. If you are replacing a panel that only goes maybe 30 degrees or 70 degrees or maybe 180 degrees and you wanted a panel to go 360, this is probably your choice. Because it, in the sense that it's covering 360 degrees, like a panel, that's probably what you're looking for, whereas a panel, normal, you know, Foxeer or Immersion RC or True RC, you know, you have a panel and you either have here, here, or you have here, here, or you have here, here for your reception sweet spot area. I think what I have here, and I'm trying to warn you, is don't make my mistake or get into my misconception of what this was, because I didn't look at the gain chart hard enough. I just took it into effect, to account that, oh, it's 360 coverage horizontally? That's awesome. So if I split one up vertically, 360 degree cover. But it's only, again, at like 20 or 30 degrees, and then it falls off precipitously. Now that you've laughed at my hammer and made me feel all bad about myself, I'm just gonna go in and, I don't know, look up surgeons for some unspecified reason to make myself feel happier. Because that's all I need in this world is that. Mighty Thor from the beautiful city of Tampa, Florida, hanging around, looking at antennas, trying to understand gain charts and all that stuff that VAS understands way better than I do. Slayer!